They haven't had Josh Howard any of the three games played in this year. Kind of different wrench to see.
He's a problem. Yeah. He's a problem. Because he's the guy that you got to really focus on, especially on that block.
Yeah.
In the mid-post, and you really got to pay attention to him, his offensive rebound capabilities, getting possessions back for his team. He's a problem.
Joshua J. Howard, born April 28, 1980. Today's feature is a guy whose game and journey I have a lot of respect for. His story can be a great example for many younger people today, as well as those that deal with the reality of society, no matter the era. Trial after trial, he had to bounce back from being placed behind the eight ball to get where he'd eventually go, and things weren't always convenient, to say the least. His journey didn't begin as normal as you would expect a former NBA All-Star story to begin, but when he finally found his stride, he was one of the best two-way players for a short amount of time that was the perfect slashing wing in his days and would have been exactly what the NBA looks for in the position today. With those physical tools, plus the following things not happening to him, Josh Howard could have been and was on the path to becoming a household name. Instead, unless you speak to a person that remembers watching Howard around 2007-2008, his name usually goes forgotten. Here are three reasons Josh Howard's growth was stunted just before he actually blossomed into his full potential. It's your boy JC Stunted Growth. Quick reminder, if you want exclusive content like workout videos, ad-free features before they release here, and more, head over to the Patreon page now and become a supporter of pushing these stories and efforts to help any young hooper not have their growth stunted. It's something I wish I had, but didn't, so is my offering to you. Appreciate you guys. Please drop a like and comment on this video, and let me know who I should do next. Enjoy the video. Howard is a 6'8 small forward from Winston-Salem, North Carolina. He was a very raw talent throughout high school that had the obvious physical tools for the game but hadn't put it all together as he would later on. Already towering over most his competition, along with his long arms, helped him to average 6 blocks and 4 steals as a high school senior, which led him to becoming an all-state performer. He wasn't highly recruited nationally, although in the area he was considered the best in North Carolina both his junior and senior season. The day before his SAT was to be taken, he was handcuffed by local undercover officers who suspected he and friends were selling drugs outside of a gas station they had been standing at what seemed to be hours. This could have been the reason he scored in the low 500s the next day on his SATs when he needed at least a 950. Or it could be for reasons we'll talk about later. Stunt number one, before his time. Looking at a player like Josh Howard, there could have been a few things that may have held him back. But one of the biggest stunts in his growth, I think, is that he was simply before his time in ways on and off the court. Ways like him being perfectly suited for this era of basketball, where his specifications as a basketball player are the exact ones coveted in today's wing players. 6'7", long-armed, high-motored slasher that can score in a variety of ways and also defend the other team's best player. That was Josh Howard. Not to say he didn't have success in his own era, just that today he'd be a star, no question. Off the floor, Howard is also known to partake in smoking marijuana prior, during, and after leaving the NBA, who's admitted to doing as much when he was interviewed by Michael Irvin right before a crucial playoff game in 2008.
I don't think it's nothing that's hidden. I think a lot of everybody, like in the media world and the sports world, know that NBA players, you know, do smoke marijuana.
You don't smoke in during the season, but you do smoke in the off season. How true is that?
Yeah, it's true. But, you know, like I was saying to the guy, that has nothing to do with what I do as far as basketball.
In those days, the NBA, along with society, weren't ready to hear this publicly, especially from an NBA player, even more before an actual league game. In these days, I think that would have been perfectly fine for him to say, and if judged or attempts to blackball him were taken, there would be a lot of support on his side on both social media and fellow players voicing their opinion and defending his free choice. But in 2008, things were a lot different, and he was from that point shadow blackballed, as not many teams wanted to be associated with his statements at the time, and it cost him important prime years of his career. Prior to the NBA, because he didn't pass his SATs, he couldn't sign to Wake Forest after his senior year for its close proximity to his hometown and family. Instead, he had to attend Hargrave Military Academy to correct his grades, where he averaged over 19 points a game and 10 rebounds before signing to Wake Forest. Immediately, his skills as a do-it-all slasher and defender were obvious. By his senior year at Wake, he was the unanimous ACC Player of the Year, First Team All-American, and named the National Player of the Year by College Insider and Basketball Digest. He averaged 19.5 points a game, 8.3 rebounds, one block, and almost two steals a game. He was considered a late lottery to mid-first round pick, but fell due to suspicions he was heavily involved in smoking marijuana, which many teams at the time couldn't wrap their heads around and didn't want to associate with. For this reason, he slipped to 29th overall, selected by the Dallas Mavericks. Stunt number two, shut up and dribble.
LeBron should shut up and dribble. I called those remarks racist. Laura Ingraham proves James' point about racism. Oh, okay.
The biggest growth stunt for Josh Howard was him saying things in the media that affected his reputation and also sort of got him blackballed from the league. The first was him admitting he smoked weed in the offseason in an interview before Game 3 of the Mavericks' first round series against New Orleans in 2008. Josh, while being interviewed by Michael Irving, stated that he does enjoy the plant, but only in the offseason, saying that if he wanted to smoke during the season though, it should be his personal choice. That statement didn't go over well, as like mentioned earlier, the league wasn't ready for a player speaking in favor of the considered drug at the time, neither were society in general. Today, with the legalization of it almost everywhere across America, that statement would not be so harsh to his reputation. Also that year, at a football event held by Allen Iverson, while the national anthem played in the background, Josh walked in front of one of the cameras and said, "I don't sing the national anthem, I'm black." This prompted backlash from every side, even publications like Bleacher Report, whom I think should be called out for their stupidity more often than not with the things they do and say as a staff on a regular basis. They literally said that Josh Howard should just shut up and dribble. We all know the controversy that surrounded reporter Laura Ingraham telling LeBron James to do the same thing in 2018 and the uproar in LeBron's defense that followed. There was none of that for Josh. Instead, he was attacked by the media, the fans, and ignorant people in that time who were looking for any and everyone to crucify for mistakes made, especially someone like Howard, coming off a career season where he averaged 20 points a game and 7 rebounds and was an all-star the season before, not to mention his brand new contract he had just signed. The timing of Josh's statements were all bad for that time, and it cost him his reputation, and I think that eventually cost him his stability in the league, as he was traded soon after, in the middle of the 2009-2010 season to the Wizards while he was still clearly a good player in the NBA. Stunt number three, overestimated his worth. And the final stunt, I'd say, that took Josh Howard from being a budding star to somewhat forgotten is that unfortunately, in society, which I don't agree with but remains true, there are hierarchies involved that create an uneven playing field for you if you happen to find yourself at the bottom or somewhere around the middle. Josh Howard was a player at the time that couldn't get away with the statements he made, and I think his success at the time got to his head and made him think he was. Don't get me wrong, you should always know your worth in every situation. But some people confuse knowing your worth with you must think your worth is maximized to everyone you meet. Sadly, but truthfully, that isn't true. In Josh's case, the league can always replace guys that are on the cusp of becoming a star or lower. The ones on a level like LeBron James or Kevin Durant or Steph Curry, a simple apology would suffice, but a guy like Josh Howard, unfavorable comments are a no-no. I honestly don't think he was thinking at the time, so I won't even fault him. I do fault society's need and want to demonize you for everything, especially a certain person at a certain level of success. Josh was not the same player in Washington after the trade, where along with the backlash and shadow balling, he dealt with a torn ACL that hindered him from staying on the floor and performing like he was supposed to have grown into. He finished his career in the league with the Minnesota Timberwolves and the D-League, where at just 32, he was finished and prime cut short. He went on to become a coach and philanthropist in the Dallas, Texas area. All in all, Josh to me was still an exciting player that was the perfect fit with Dirk Nowitzki and played at a very high level when he was still in the running to become a star in the league. Unfortunately, the time we were in the early to mid-2000s, were not ready for a player or person like Josh, and it hurt his career. Either way, salute to him, he was still a straight hooper, and I think nothing he did was wrong and he should have played to at least 37 years old. But for these reasons, his growth was stunted. It's your boy JC Stunted Growth, and I'm out.